I see multitudes, huh? I see multitudes.
Gotta be for 20 years.
Oh, he did 47 yesterday also? That's the one I studied for. So you did 45, 46, and 47 yesterday, huh? Well, 48's on the board.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay.
Just go into the details too much on it.
Okay. It's the last verse of the chapter. Tomorrow you start a new chapter in your life. A little brass section here. Jayo Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Jayo Radha
Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Jayo Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Gobi Janavallabha Giri Vardhari. Janavallabha Giri Vardhari. Yasoda Nandana Braja Janaranjana.
Yasoda Nandana Braja
Janaranjana. Munatira Banachari.
Yamunatira Banachari.
Yamunatira Banachari.
Yamunatira Banachari.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunjabihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari.
Gopi Janna Ballabha Giri Vardhari.
Gopi Janna Ballabha Giri Vardhari.
Gopi Janna Ballabha Giri Vardhari.
Gopi Janavallabha Giri Vardhari.
Yasoda Nandana Braja Janaranjana.
Yasoda Nandana Braja Janaranjana.
Yasoda Nandana Braja Janaranjana. Yasoda Nandana Braja Janaranjana. Jamuna Tira Banachari. Jamuna Tira Banachari. Jayo Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Sri Radha Madhava ki, Sri Radha Giridhari ki, Gaura Premanande, Jai Om Vishnu Pada Paramahamsa, Puri Vraj Kajaja Shudha Sisi Mahari Divine Grace of Vai, Janamara Vinda Bhakti Vranta Swami, Shira Prabhupada ki jai, Jai Om Vishnu Pada Paramahamsa, Puri Vraj Kajaja Shudha Sisi Mahari Divine Grace, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Gosam Maharaj Prabhupada ki jai, Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrinda ki jai, Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Samaveda Bhaktivinoda ki jai. All glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glories, Sisi Guru and Siddhi Gauranga. All glories to the unassembled devotees. Back, you know, wherever they may be. The unassembled devotees. So this morning reading from the Srimad Bhagavatam, third canto, 30. First chapter, the last verse of the chapter, 48. And then only about two more chapters on Lord Kapila Dev. And that's the the end of this canto, correct? This is the last volume? Volume 4, yes. Then we go to the fifth canto, you can hear about hell. Okay. Om namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 Narayanam namaskrityam naram chaiva narottamam devim saraswatim vyasam tato jamudiriyat. Samyag darshanaya buddhya,
Samyag darshanaya buddhya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Maya virachite loke,
Maya virachite loke,
Charanyasa kalevaram,
Charanyasa kalevaram,
Samyag darshanaya buddhya,
Samyag darshanaya buddhya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Maya virachate loke,
Maya virachate loke,
Charanyasa kalevaram,
Charanyasa kalevaram,
Samyak darshanaya buddhya,
Samyak darshanaya buddhya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Maya virachate loke,
Maya virachate
Charanyasa kalevaram,
Charanyasa kalevaram,
Samyak darshanaya buddhya,
Samyak darshanaya buddhya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Maya virachate loke,
Maya virachate loke,
Charanyasa kalevaram,
Charanyasa kalevaram.
Please chant.
Samyak darshanaya buddhya,
Samyak darshanaya buddhya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Yoga vairagya yuktaya,
Maya virachate loke,
maya virachate loke
jaranya sa kalevaram
samyak darshanaya bodhya
yoga vairagya yuktaya
maya virachate loke
janya sa kalevaram
samyak darshanaya bodhya
yoga vairagya yuktaya
maya virachate loke
charanya sa kalevaram
sir
samyak darshanaya buddhya
yoga vairagya yuktaya
maya virachate loke
charanya sa kalevaram
before we go any further Janardhan Prabhu do the cloths need to be folded are there buckets of unfolded cloth or everything's folded not to say you bring it if anyone needs to do that during class so this is our word for word synonyms samyak darshanaya
endowed with right vision
buddhya
through reason
yoga
by devotional service
vairagya
by detachment
yuktaya
strengthened
Maya virachate,
arranged by Maya.
Loke,
to this world.
Charet,
one should move about.
Nyasa,
relegating.
Kalevaram,
the body.
Translation
and purport by Srila Prabhupada.
Endowed
with right vision.
And
strengthened by devotional
service and
a pessimistic
attitude towards
material identity,
one
should relegate
his body
to this illusory
world
through his reason.
Thus,
one can be
unconcerned
with this
material world.
Wow.
You ready?
Endowed
with right vision.
And
strengthened
by devotional service.
And
a pessimistic
attitude.
Towards
material
identity,
one
should
relegate
his body
to
this illusory
world
through
his reason.
Thus
one can be
unconcerned
with
this material
world.
Purport.
It
is sometimes
misunderstood
that
if one has
to associate
with persons
engaged in
devotional service,
he will not
be able to
solve
the
economic
problem.
Once
Srila Prabhupada
was asked this
question, if
everyone
gave
everything up
and became
a devotee,
what would
happen
to the world?
One reporter
asked him.
Prabhupada said,
don't worry,
there will be
fools and rascals
like you
who
won't give
up.
So
different answers
were given
at different
times.
One time,
someone
asked
Prabhupada,
if everyone
in the world
was just
like you,
what would
the world
be like?
And
Prabhupada
says,
like every
tree
would have
flowers
on it,
every,
you know,
just like,
it's Vaikuntha.
Imagine
if everyone in
this world was
just like
Srila
Prabhupada.
So
that
reporter
set himself
up.
But
anyways,
the question
is there,
the doubt
is there.
To answer
this
argument, it
is
described
here
that
one
has to
associate
with
liberated
persons
not
directly
physically,
but by
understanding
through
philosophy
and logic
the
problems
of life.
It
is stated
here,
samyag
darshanaya
buddhya.
One
has to
see
perfectly,
and
by
intelligence
and
yogic
practice,
one
has
to
renounce
this
world.
That
renunciation
can be
achieved
by
the process
recommended
in the
second
chapter
of
the
first
canto
of
Srimad
Bhagavatam.
Someone
want to look
that
up? You know
what that
one is?
That's
where we
begin,
Nasta Pareshu
Abhidarishu,
that whole
list
of verses.
Actually,
if someone
can
open
up,
you go
to
the Bhagavad
Gita,
seventh
chapter,
one or
two
purports
in,
I think
it
has that...
That
whole list
of verses
in the
Bhagavatam,
second
chapter.
The
devotee's
intelligence
is always
in touch
with
the Supreme
Personality
of Godhead. His attitude towards the material existence is one of detachment, for he knows perfectly well that this material world is a creation of illusory energy. Realizing himself to be part and parcel of the Supreme Soul, the devotee discharges his devotional service and is completely aloof from material action and reaction. Thus, at the end, he gives up his material body or the material energy, and as a pure soul, he enters the kingdom of God. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta purports of the third canto, 31st chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam, entitled Lord Kapila's Instructions on the Movements of the Living Entities. Om Agyanti Varandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksul Unminitam Nena Taismai Siddhi Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Nena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svabhadandikam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasati Gaur Bhaktivarinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Banchaka Badru Bhashya Kripa Shindu Bevacha Patitanam Bhavani Bho Vaishnavi Bho Namo Namaha Durgame Patimindas Esklap Parakitir Mahu Svakripa Yasti Dhanena Santa Santa Valambanam. You know that verse, huh? It's the hiking verse.
The hiking verse.
Yes. So, do I have your permission to try to say something? I got 2 out of 4, that's not bad. Okay. Endowed with right vision and strengthened by devotional service and a pessimistic attitude towards material identity, one should relegate his body to this illusory world through his reason. Thus, one can be unconcerned with this material world. Now, in the Sanskrit here, it's giving some what actually brings about this samyak darshanaya, right vision or correct vision. Buddhya means through reason, yoga means by devotional service, vairagya means detachment. So one's proper vision in life is not simply book knowledge. Reason or logic is there. Of course, the practice of devotional service and by detachment. And that's what strengthens our vision of, you can say our devotional service, but what's referred to here as our vision, our understanding of reality. It's very important because unless one is willing to engage in the process of devotional service, which includes cultivation of knowledge and detachment. What is that verse? Jnana vairaga yuktaya. You know that one in the Bhagavatam? Jnana vairaga yuktaya. So both have to be there. There's no spiritual path without jnana and vairag. It's a show. It's cheating. And that's what the Bhagavatam says. What is the beginning of the Bhagavatam? Dharma projita kaitavo. That cheating religion is kicked out. What's cheating religion? Well, it means not devotional service. It just means religion in the sense of an application or a process for enjoying in this material world. That's cheating. Because the purpose of devotional service is to get our spiritual life or religion is to get us out of this material world. So if it's keeping us in, we're being cheated. You know, just like if I give you a wooden nickel, am I cheating you? Because it's worthless, right? Giving you something is not the real. It's not the real thing. I got cheated. I went to Vrindavan. I'll tell you a story. My wife, for the first and only time she went to Vrindavan, she bought a sari, and the man said it was silk. So she comes back to the ashram, and I forget the name of the Mataji, Leela. Anyway, so she got cheated. It's synthetic. It's not silk at all. So she's pretty upset. So she brings me back to Loy Bazaar, to the merchant, and sits there and says, I got a problem here. I said, you told me this was silk, but it's not silk, it's synthetic. You cheated me. And of course, in the usual Vrindavan merchant way, he goes, whatever I said, I may have said, but do not call me a cheater. Whatever I said, I may have said, but do not call me a cheater. What do you call someone who sells you something that's synthetic and it's not, you tell them it's silk? So that was it. That was his excuse. He said, but do not call me a cheater. And then Jen got it back and got a real one. But that was kind of interesting. Don't call me a cheater. I cheated you yesterday. I sold you a synthetic sari and I told you it was silk and I charged you through the nose. But don't call me a cheater. Anyways, businessmen, what can you do? Right, that was funny. You know, just like this year when I bought that loader there for the deities, I went to the shop. He said, "No, this is solid brass, and we won't, you know." And then he rattled off the rupees, and I paid him and said, "Wait a second, that's $70. He said, "That's ridiculous. You can buy this in America for $20, $30. And he goes, "Hmm." And he said, I said, "Just give me my money back, my rupees back." You know, he goes, no, I cannot do that. I said, "What's going on?" He said, "You're the first customer of the day. I have to sell it to you." I said, "But I'm not going to pay $70. So he goes, $50. I said, "That's ridiculous." He said, "Then $40. That's ridiculous." Then I got it down to 30, and I started calculating how much that was, and I bought some brass. And so I got it went from $75 down to 30. And he kept saying, "Oh, I cannot give you your money back because you're the first customer of the day. It is good luck." And I was thinking, good luck cheating someone? But anyways, you know, hold your tongue. They're Brajbasis, you know, whatever. But anyways, cheating is there, right? Cheating is there. So Kaitava Dharma means you engage someone in the process of just staying in the material world in the name of religion. Actually, it's the greatest cheating. So the point is we have to develop this right vision. And when Prabhupada, in these purports, in so many places, when Prabhupada says devotee, who's he referring to? The devotee is a whole gamut, a whole, you know, from the highest to the lowest, but what's being described here is a very elevated platform of a devotee because he has the right vision. That's something we're aspiring for. We have a little bit of it, but as you go through the purport here, this is a very advanced devotee because he's endowed with, he's actually come to the point of that vision is granted to him by Krishna because of his following the process, being reason or logic, engaged in devotional service, which purifies the heart, and then detachment, practicing detachment, and gradually what happens, one's vision is not just theoretical. That's the difference between jnana and vijnana. Sometimes it's translated like that. Jnana means book knowledge. Vijnana means realized knowledge. You actually see it. You actually see it. It's not theoretical. It's actually how you now see things. Just like when someone has cataracts. You know what happens when you have cataracts? What happens to your vision, Janardan? You know, do you know? Well, it gets very, very cloudy. And you can, it almost covers it up, you know, cataracts. It's a growth over the eyes. And that's why I have cataract surgery. They just remove that and people can see. There's this story Radhanath Maharaj tells about this doctor in probably Mumbai. And they have a whole clinic, eye clinic, that goes to Vrindavan and different places. And these doctors volunteer. And he's a nice devotee like that, but quite well-to-do, very, very wealthy and so on. And wasn't so much involved in the temple and so on. But anyways, he started going and volunteering his time. And it was in Vrindavan, maybe a two-week clinic. And most of the operations is cataracts, you know, cataracts. And he said that what changed his life was he operated on this one old Brijbasi woman. Like, you know, never been to a doctor in her life. But the cataracts were so bad, she was more or less blind, like that. So he did the operation and so on, and then he took off the bandage. She could see. And then for the first time in years and years and years, so she started dancing around, and Radhe, 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 and then she took her hand and was hitting him on the head, blessing him, like, "May Radharani bless you, may Radharani bless this old woman." And he said he just started crying. He's just in ecstasy, you know, and he helped this Brijbasi, but she was hitting him on the head, "Radharani, bless you, Radharani, bless you," and she was dancing that she could see. So the cataract was removed, and she could see for the first time in probably decades properly. So that vision, we're all aspiring for it, because once you get it, then devotional service is much easier, just like what's the platform when devotional service becomes no longer a struggle? Nishta, that means steady. Why? Because we have this kind of vision. We have this kind of vision. And it's not something we're aspiring for. It's something, it's just Krishna in the heart. What is that verse? Tesam satayuktanam bhajatam pratipur. Dadami buddhi yogam tam hinam amupinyat. He says, I give you the buddhi, the intelligence, to come to me. I'll give it to you. I'm in your heart. I'll give it to you. It's a gift. But we have to qualify for it. We have to qualify for it. We have to be ready for it. Like that. But it's a gift that Krishna gives, that buddhi yogam, and it's to attain him. He's not going to give us a big brain to become a big scientist or this or that. Krishna's not really, I mean, if you really, really want it, Krishna can give it to you, but we're talking about devotees. What's the intelligence the devotee wants, and what's the intelligence that Krishna will gladly give? It's how to come to him, back home, back to Godhead. Is it really intelligence how to figure out how to be happy in this material world? Right? Just like if you're in prison, there are some prisoners, and they're lifers, right? So all they're doing is working on how to be happy for the rest of their life in prison. All the wheeling and dealing, and we used to crack jokes, oh, extra jello. But now it's, you know exactly what it is. It's drugs and money, and they're some people are actually running a whole, crime ring right from prison. In fact, I don't know all the details, but the governor of Rhode Island, maybe 2 decades ago or something like that, while he was still the governor, he was in jail for something. It's a pretty corrupt state, Rhode Island, from what I understand. He was running the state from jail. He was arrested, put in jail, and he's running the state. He was still the governor, even though he's in jail. Interesting history. You can look that one up. So, but the point is, I have very good intelligence. How to be happy in this jail or in prison. Is that real intelligence? No, real intelligence is how to get out. How to get out. So, Prabhupada begins the purport by saying, sometimes it's misunderstood that if you're associating with persons engaged in devotional service, you'll not be able to solve one's economic problem. In other words, and this is in the previous purport also, this yukta vairagya, right? And palgu vairagya, false renunciation. Was that covered yesterday? Did he talk about that yesterday? Palgu vairagya, this is a verse by Rupa Goswami. Like that. When you see things in this material world having no connection with Krishna, that's palgu vairagya, and you give it up. Everything is the Lord's property. So there's nothing wrong with economic development. In fact, there has to be economic development, otherwise no one's happy. Just like if tomorrow not one person donated one penny to this temple, what's going to happen?
No more temple.
No more temple. No more prasad. No more dhotis and kurtas, and there's nothing. Their money has to be there. Nothing wrong with money. It's the proper use of it. So it's a misunderstanding what detachment is. And they're saying here, the Prabhupada says, the answer to the arguments described here that one has to associate with liberated persons, not directly physically, but by understanding through philosophy and logic the problems of life. So in other words, that's the real association. And that's what we want to encourage people when they're coming. That's when real association starts, when people want to hear and try to understand Krishna consciousness, delve into it. That's when the association actually becomes very meaningful, right? Just like Prabhupada gives the example, just like a king is sitting on a throne, so a fly may be on his knee. So what benefit is that fly getting? In fact, he's not careful, he's going to get a royal swat. Right? So is that association? Just being in the proximity of the king? No, there's no real benefit for that fly. So just being near someone, it's assimilating the teachings of the saintly persons. It says, it is stated here, has to see perfectly, and by intelligence and yogic practice, one has to renounce this world. So the renunciation of this material world, or it probably says in the verse, unconcerned with the material world, that only comes about by the cultivation of these different things, devotional service and detachment, yukta vairagya, jnana vairagya yuktaya, being endowed with these things, knowledge and renunciation. And these things have to increase the longer and longer we're here in practicing devotional service. That is a barometer of our advancement, that one has more knowledge and one is more and more renounced. Right. That doesn't mean one gets a big fat head and reads all kinds of books, and every year they're wearing less and less clothing. In 10 years, you're walking around just in Copens or something. That doesn't mean that. Right. That I'm just renouncing. Right. That it's the mentality that I am the enjoyer of this material world, and I want to stay here, like that. It says here this pessimistic attitude towards material identity. That's very important too, because sometimes the criticism is there that we're very, very pessimistic people. You come to a lecture, birth, death, disease, and old age, the body's nothing but a bag of stool and urine, all kinds of stuff like that, right? Very, very pessimistic. like that. You're just going to die. Right? I think I told you, there was a story I heard recently. There's a devotee, Urjaswat. You know Urjaswat? And there's a devotee, Dramila. You know Dramila? Okay. So Dramila, he was in L.A. and he was a guest. And he was, as many people back in the 70s were, following a macrobiotic diet. And that was the big thing. I forget the gentleman's name from Japan or wherever, macrobiotic. So he sat down at a Sunday feast and he wouldn't eat anything. So I'm a macrobiotic diet. And the Urjaswat was next to him. He turned and said, "Don't you know, you're going to die. Just eat it." And it shocked him. And he just ate the whole feast, the halava and every street rice. And then he moved in. He said, "You're going to die. Eat it." That's Urjaswat. Pretty powerful devotee like that. So anyways, that's what happens. That's what happens. So this, you know, I mean, as far as being pessimistic about this world, it's just, actually we're just realistic. But we have to be very careful how we preach to people. And one can't give up a lower taste until they get a higher taste. You know that verse in Bhagavad Gita, second chapter? Param dushtva navartate. You've heard that one line? Yeah. One gives up the lower taste by experiencing higher taste. In fact, that's the only way one can actually progress properly. There's got to be, just like a child, right? The child has something in its hand, you want to get it, you have to give them something they think is better. No, you just take this. Oh, okay, just like that. So in the exact same way, we will not be pessimistic about this material world and material identity unless we have something better. And where do we get the taste for Krishna consciousness? Where's the real reservoir of nectar? Chanting. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's process of chanting Hare Krishna. In fact, if you read carefully, Chaitanya Charitamrita, and especially books like Chaitanya Bhagavata describing Lord Chaitanya, he's always chanting and dancing in ecstasy in all his devotees. And these are very, very exalted levels of Krishna consciousness. That is kirtan, where they're actually crying in ecstasy and laughing, rolling on the ground, and it's just unbelievable. And that's a kirtan. That's a kirtan. That's what kirtan is. We're trying to get to that level. In other words, it just like it says in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the Lord Chaitanya broke open the storehouse of love of God. Now, what's a storehouse? Yeah, it's like a warehouse. You know, just like you drive through some of these industrial parks, you see these huge warehouses, like off of 15, and you know, they're like 100 different of those big semi-trucks backed up in there. It's a huge distribution center, a storehouse. So who knows how big the storehouse of love of God is? It's big enough to inundate all of creation. That's a pretty big storehouse. So as Lord Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya broke it open and caused the flood. Right? And that's through the chanting of the holy name. So that's what's available. But somehow or other, you know, we won't touch it. We won't get our feet wet. Right? Just like you go to the ocean, oh, a little cold, like someone touches the water with their toe. So we're on the edge of this ocean of nectar, and we're just, because we don't have right vision like that. We're thinking there's something else over here, maybe not that. But it's that is the happiness that's being offered to us, and the more and more one becomes absorbed in the process of chanting and serving Krishna, one experiences a higher taste. That all of this, it becomes very easy. One becomes unconcerned. What was your favorite toy when you were maybe 5 or 6 years old?
Probably just
plastic toy gun. Now, has anyone seen Dr. Zach upstairs with a plastic toy gun in his locker or anything like that? No, but you gave it up, right? In fact, if I were even to buy you one, you'd say, why in the world do you waste? I have no attraction to playing with this gun anymore. But then, if someone tried to touch it, you'd probably fight him, right? Or something like that. And you'd scream and yell if your parents took it away from you. That's everything, my everything, my everything. But now it's completely unconcerned. You have something better to do. So That's the proof of we're advancing Krishna consciousness. We just have something better to do. We're just not interested in these things. And that's proper vision. So, but it comes about through the cultivation of devotional service, this buddhya or jnana, and by detachment. That's extremely important. So this is all available to us. It's a process. That process is a scientific process. We engage in the process properly. All these things become manifest. There's that verse in the Bhagavad Gita. Many, many persons became purified by this process of devotional service. I forget how that begins. But it's, in other words, it's been going on eternally. It's not we're the first ones trying it out, right? We're the experiment or something. You know, just like in modern psychology, they'll do an experiment, you know, in education to see how it's all going to work out. Just like my oldest daughter, Chintamani, she went to one school for maybe a few months here in San Diego. It was a progressive school where the parents, teachers, and students were all on the same level. Talk about a recipe for disaster. In other words, the kids had just as much say on their education as the teachers in the classroom. Well, kids, what do you want to learn today? Nothing. Okay. Right? Ridiculous. So she smelled a rat right away and said, get me out of here. Yeah, I don't think that place is still around, but, you know, so it's an experiment. You know, let's see if this works or this works. So we're not an experiment. This is a process since time immemorial, Krishna says. Since time immemorial, the process of yoga is there. So to the extent we want to develop this vision, it's available, but we have to work at it. And that work really means attracting the attention and the mercy of the spiritual master in Krishna. That's where it comes from. It doesn't come from inside the book or something like that. When the spiritual master, what is that verse? Sung every single morning, verse number 8, Mangalartik. Yasya prasada, Bhagavat prasada, yasya prasada, nagadi katopi. What does that mean? Damodar. Yeah, exactly. You have to get the mercy. So that without it, you can't make any advancement. That's what Bishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is saying. You can't make any advancement. So that's where it comes from, attracting the mercy of Guru and Krishna. Then that advancement comes. So really all we're doing all day long is trying to attract the mercy of our spiritual master, of the Vaishnavas, and Krishna, which means Krishna. And then all these things become revealed to us. It's that revelation means Krishna's revealing it to us. The impersonalists will say, the universe is revealing it to me. What does that mean anyways? The universe is revealing it to me. I mean, that's exactly what it means. There's a person there, you know, just like if you call, you have a problem. Who's the temple, handles the phones at the temple and the Wi-Fi? Is it Cox or is it AT&T or who is it? Time Warner, right? So you got a problem. You say, oh, call Time Warner. Well, it's a person at Time Warner who's going to solve your problem. It's not Time Warner, some big building somewhere. So this, the universe is going to reveal something to me. How rude, right? Krishna, in the heart, he's going to reveal it to us. He wants to give it to us, just wants to make sure we can handle it. You know, just like you go to give something to someone, they got to put their hand out. Hey, Prabhu, you know those samosas you want? Here's 6 of them. But you got to put your hand out. If you don't put your hand out, I'm not going to drop it, right? Just drop it. There's samosas. Who doesn't, right? So putting our hand out means we qualify ourselves for the mercy. But the samosas are there. Krishna's all ready to give us all the mercy we need. But we have to put our hands out and keep them out there and hold it. So we can end here. Are there any questions or comments on the last verse of this chapter? Yes, Prabhu. Where did you find out about chanting Hare Krishna and taking prasadam? Your spiritual master.
Well,
Yeah, well, I mean, spiritual master means you're Diksha Guru, Shiksha Gurus, Gurus, Vaishnavas, devotees. That's their mercy also. They've given you the process of devotional service, and you're executing it. So all that's mixed in together, but it's everything's by the mercy of one's, the devotees, the Vaishnavas. In fact, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, in Kali Yuga, the only religion is the Vaishnavas. The chanting of the holy names and association of Vaishnavas, that's it in Kali Yuga. That's all there is as far as the true religion. So it's all contained in that package of the mercy of the devotees. Just like ISKCON is the manifestation of Prabhupada's mercy, isn't it? It's nothing else but that. In fact, I remember once I was coming to the temple in Boston. Do you know Viva Swan? Did you ever know Viva Swan? Interesting devotee, quite a far out devotee, but he was a brahmachari and he was sitting there at a Sunday.
He's at the temple.
Yeah, yeah, he's in Florida, yeah, yeah. So he was there as a brahmachari when I joined. And some guest was saying, I heard that this ISKCON is just an expansion of your spiritual master's ego. And he said, that's absolutely correct. And what is that ego? I'm an eternal servant of Krishna. And just deflated the person right there. Yes, it's true. ISKCON is an expansion of Prabhupada's ego. And what is that ego? I'm eternal servant of Krishna. So, very good question. Hope I answered it enough. So we can end here. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Radhe, Radhe. How about it?